Samwel R Kitinya namna sana kwa sababu sisi tulikuwa kiongozi wa sana. I want to testify about 5 years ago at the time when I was in low level. I do remember it was on 20th of October 2011. It was the time when I was in Port 3, but at the same time it was the time when God gave me the privilege of leading my own level school as a head prefect, but also as a general secretary of Kupata. I do remember on that same day of 20th of October 2011, after dismissing the people from Asembo into their classes or returning back to the classroom, and immediately I met the sitting young boy, who was a former boy. And when that boy saw me, he began to run away because he was a late comer. But I myself, I was a runner. Therefore, I decided to chase the boy. By the moment when I was about to approach them and catch the boy, in front of us, there was a school fence. To put it in a vernacular thing, you can call it senior fence. Because the boy was shot, he just nipped through the fence and passed away. But because I was tall, there was two senior wires which were installed as our fence. Therefore, I just jumped the downward wire and approached the upward wire. And the upward wire put me down off base. I was fell down, and also I was bruised here on my left part of the eye. At the same time, I was bleeding, but I didn't convince at the time. Then, after receiving the first aid from my teacher there at Dem Secondary School, they ordered me to go to Mount Hospital to have the further treatment, our regional hospital in Arusha. Well, when I reached at the hospital, it was confirmed by the doctors, if that edge of the wire could penetrate deeper into the skin of my eye, then I could be blind. Then, after receiving the intensive treatment, I had to come back to school to keep things going so that I can reach my goals. And I remember many of my friends came up to me and were very much sorry for what had happened. But among many of my friends, I never will forget a certain young girl. Her name was called as Elmina Peter, and I must testify that she was one of the finest classmates which I've ever had. Put in mind, I didn't say she was one of my finest girlfriends. I said she was one of the finest classmates which I've ever had. That girl simply came up to me and told me, Mr. HP, I'm very much sorry for what had happened to you. I'm having the misfortune and the accident which you had today morning. But I'm simply happy to say unto you that I'm happy that the accident really caused you to be blind. And that is what I want to testify to, that I too am happy that the accident didn't cause me to be blind. Because if I was blind, then I wouldn't be around on 29th of July 2013, when the government of this nation sent me to begin my advanced level studies at Sanyeju High School. But maybe I would be taken from special group school where blind people are studying over there. I tried to figure out if I was blind. Then I wouldn't be around later that year in September, when once again I was elected to be the head prefect of Sanyeju High School, but also general secretary of Kupata, because I know something. A blind person cannot lead the normal sight person, but the normal sight person can lead a blind person. If I was blind, then I couldn't testify the kind of leadership in which you have and the kind of people's ministry and have the chance to pray. I tried to figure out if I was blind, then I wouldn't be here testifying what the Lord had done in me. And I'm happy that in spite of that accident, it didn't cause me to have any kind of eye defect. Whether it is hypermyopia, whether it is myopia, whether it is night blindness or cataract, there is no anything like that. But I'm simply happy to say that I cannot see like an eagle, but I can see in the sense of eagle. May God bless you.